Hi, I'm Cody from Duo, part of Cisco Secure. If you're deploying Duo as any kind of administrator, be it help desk, application or user manager, or even an owner admin, you'll need to know how the Duo admin panel works. Every aspect of your Duo system can be managed from the admin panel. In this tutorial, we'll walk through admin panel website navigation and highlight the top administrative actions and reporting capabilities to fine-tune the user experience for your Duo installation. Along the way, we'll call out underrated features and settings, so be sure to watch until the end. For more information, reference our documentation at duo.com/docs/administration. You can also become a Duo Certified Level 1 Administrator for free with Duo's Admin Panel Essentials Course Series, designed for IT and network administrators, which takes about 90 minutes to complete. The courses and certification exam are available at our self-paced learning platform, levelup.duo.com, or by scanning the QR code on screen now. Duo Admin Panel features vary depending on which Duo edition you have, MFA, Access, or Beyond. In this video walkthrough, we'll be using the Beyond edition, being accessed by an administrator with the owner role. Certain features are available or hidden based on Duo administrator roles. You can learn more about these roles in the Duo documentation. To access the Duo admin panel, open a supported web browser and navigate to admin.duosecurity.com. Now, if this is the first time you're accessing the Duo admin panel as an admin for your organization, you'll likely have an account setup link from your organization's Duo owners via email, text message, or another method of communication. Click that link to begin the setup process. If your admin password will be stored in Duo, click Create Password to set your password. If your organization uses single sign-on with its own identity provider or IDP for Duo admin panel logons, then click Create Account using single sign-on and sign in at your IDP with primary username and password. After completing either of these steps, you'll see a QR code for Duo Push activation. This refers to the out-of-band auth mechanism delivered via the Duo mobile app. Next, install Duo Mobile on your Android or iOS device and scan the QR code that comes up for you after logon. Next, confirm or enter your phone number to be considered a backup phone number for Duo admin panel logins. Note that if you skip the Duo push activation, you'll need to verify ownership of the phone number by entering a passcode received by text or phone call before you can continue with setup. After setup, click the Continue to Duo Admin Panel Login button. Enter the email address for your Duo Administrator account. You may check the box marked Save My Email Address for Next Time, and Duo will save the email address and also save your login preference for a quicker login experience the next time you access the admin panel. Click Continue. Enter the password for your administrator account and click Login. The screen will update and require you to complete second-factor authentication to complete your login. The standard methods of secondary authentication include Duo Push, Text Me, Call Me, and Passcode. We'll select Duo Push and approve the request on Duo Mobile. If for some reason you enter the wrong password or passcode, or your 2FA request times out, that results in a failed login attempt. After 10 failed login attempts, your admin account will be locked out. Details for unlocking accounts can be found in the Duo documentation. Website navigation. Now that we're logged into our Duo admin panel, let's focus on where things are and how to get things done fast. The first page your admin panel loads into is the dashboard. The dashboard gives you a snapshot of your organization's activity, and it's a great place to quickly see the overall details on users, endpoints, authentications, and more. At the top of your dashboard, you might see a recommendation modal for a product or feature that could squeeze more value out of your Duo edition. In this case, we can learn more about Duo's passwordless solution and a series of steps on how to configure and enable it. Back to our dashboard, the modal can be dismissed, allowing for more screen real estate for authentications reporting. If you think of the dashboard as a newspaper, the details above the fold, or visually available on the upper half of the page, tend to be those that you'll use the most. And generally, they have more than one link for quick access. For instance, you can use the navigation links on the left sidebar, but you can also access users, endpoints, administrators, 2FA devices, groups, trust monitor, and billing information from the top three columns of your dashboard. Below the user and endpoint summaries is a visual depiction of your organization's authentications and the authentication log, which lists information about the last 10 Duo login attempts. For even more details, click Full Authentication Log to be taken to the Logs page, where you can filter your results and export or print the log. We'll click the dashboard link to continue our navigation lesson. To the right of the authentication log is the What's New feed. This is where Duo posts select enhancements to the Duo service, separated by both date and feature. Now, for all feature news, fixes, and updates to Duo's service and applications, we recommend that you click the Read Release Notes link, which opens a tab to the Duo community. Here you can read Duo release notes and learn how to subscribe to future release notes. Now let's talk about completing tasks. Depending on your administrative role, you might use the Duo Admin panel a little differently from other admins in the security industry, or even within your own organization. Your work might have you adding or updating users or devices, sending enrollment codes, or assessing why an auth might have failed. Other owner admins might be setting up and protecting applications, defining security policies, or even creating a risk profile to discover and remediate security events. The great thing? All of these tasks can be accomplished in the same Duo Admin panel and all from the left sidebar navigation system. Let's quickly show where to complete some top help desk admin tasks. First, if we want to add a new user, click the Add New drop-down button and select User. Enter the username that matches their primary authentication username and click the Add User button. The page will refresh and allow you to fill out the rest of the user's details, set their status, and add them to any necessary groups, add a phone, hardware token, or security key, and also send them an enrollment email. To update an existing user or their devices, click on Users in the left sidebar, and then click the username you need to update. You could also search for this user from any page within the Duo Admin panel. Now, before you or another admin makes a change request, we recommend that you verify the user's identity. We can do this by clicking the Send Duo Push link once on the user's page. Scrolling down on the user's page also allows us to add a new phone to their account or reactivate Duo Mobile, which allows you to generate a new activation code for their phone's Duo Mobile application. You can also select the expiration duration for the new code. This is a great time to mention that Instant Restore allows your users to reconnect Duo protected accounts when they get a new device. To turn on and allow Instant Restore for Duo Mobile within the admin panel, click Settings and then click Duo Mobile App. To the right of Instant Restore, select the radio button to allow instant restore, and then click the Save Changes button. Now, if your role is more owner admin and less help desk, one of the first tasks we recommend is adding an additional administrator. The owner role is the only role that can create, update, or delete other admins, and also the only role that can activate Duo Single Sign-On or passwordless features. To add another administrator, click Administrators in the left sidebar, and then click the Add Administrator button. If your role includes protecting applications with Duo, click Applications in the left sidebar, and then on the Applications page, click the Protect an Application button. From there, you can either use the in-page search bar to find the application you wish to protect, or scroll down to see the applications in alphabetical order, as well as details on their protection type, Duo documentation links, and the Protect button to begin the configuration. For admins focused on policies, clicking on Policies in the left sidebar will bring you to the Duo Policy Engine. Here you can edit your global policy, as well as scroll down and add a new custom policy. This would be where we could add a Remember Devices policy for our users if we didn't already have one. For admin roles focused on reporting, clicking on Reports from the left sidebar will do two things. The authentication log from the dashboard will load into view, and a series of additional reporting resources will show up in the left sidebar, including, but not limited to, authentication summary, which can be customized for certain date ranges, denied authentications, which highlights your auth failure rate and reasoning, administrator actions, and policy impact. All administrator roles except billing can view reports. The bottom half of the left sidebar admin panel navigation includes valuable links to connect with Duo support, should you have issues. Under Need Help is a link to contact and view any existing support tickets for your org. Note that you will need your account ID information from the admin panel if you contact Duo Support. Your account ID is also visible in the top right of the admin panel to the left of your profile drop-down menu. Now, above your account ID are the versioning details for your admin panel. This information can help determine which Duo release updates apply to your account. Below your account ID includes a series of helpful links that will continue to expand your knowledge of Duo. Clicking on your deployment ID forwards you to Duo status page, which shows the current health of our various deployments, as well as resolution details on any past incidents. Documentation will take you to the Duo Docs page. Clicking on User Guide opens up an end user guide intended for organizations that already have deployed Duo. Here, your end users can learn more about two-factor authentication and the why behind it, as well as supported devices and how to set up Duo Mobile. Knowledge Base will open help.duo.com and provide an easy way to search for and explore Knowledge Base articles by topic. Clicking on Level Up, Training and Certification will open the free Duo Level Up self-paced admin training and courses certification opportunities that all Duo customers have access to. And Community will open up the previously mentioned Duo Community. Thanks for watching our video walkthrough of the Duo Admin Panel. For more information, please visit the Duo Docs or get started with the Duo Level Up Admin Panel Essentials course series to learn even more for free.